Hey yo, it's your boy Los. Let's get it.
Through the course of my life, I've been a letdown, but I promise that I'm better in the head now. Cause with the truth, I'll be giving up, play around. Now bow down to the guy who was saving clown like me. Spirit came round by 40 guys writing me. Focused on the purpose and the working of my king. Took me from a slave to a servant of the right thing. Bloodshed red, but it's working like a white thing. In the end, it'll be quicker than lightning strikes. Every change, then no longer be a fight between the flesh and the spirit that's living inside me. That's on the daily, I fight me. The word be the sword for the cutting of the cords on the ties that bind with the balance for the mind of my ears. Never open as I heard from the Lord. Through the preacher, he determined to speak into my life. Show enough. Yeah. He came through tough. He's everywhere at all times. Still shows up. He knew that I would fail him and he still showed love by coming down and dying on the real rose up. Praise God. And everywhere I go, even through the valley, I try to follow every jot and every tittle of the Holy Bible. And I hide it in my heart because it saved my soul. So yippee-ki-yay, yo. If you're thirsting for the word, then I got the hydro. All
right. So, it's been a long time coming, and I know my man is like on the edge of his seat, like, what's he gonna say? It's his fault, he brought this upon himself. Nah, shout out to my guy, T. Barlow. As you see, we're talking about T. Barlow and his latest album, Mixtape, actually, the Underground Railroad Mixtape type joint. And it's funny, right? So, Barlow gave this album to me about a month ago? Maybe 2 months ago. So I've been bumping it for a long time. I'm getting a feel for it, just loving it, enjoying it. And then I was getting ready to do my review, and then he hit me back and said, yo, we're going to take some time and get some other stuff situated, blah, blah, blah. He hit me back when it's time. And so I hadn't bumped it for a while. And so then he hit me up, like, Wednesday. He's like, yo, we're dropping it on Saturday. I'm like, dang, I got to hear the album again. Just make sure I know what I'm trying to say. So I went back, heard it again, and was blessed all over again. Dope album. Shout out to my guy, man. And I say that not loosely. And everything that I'm going to say, he's already heard me say before. So to those who don't know our relationship or haven't heard our conversations, it could come across disrespectful, but I promise you, in my heart of hearts, nothing I'm getting ready to say is disrespectful to my guy. Barlow hit me back maybe a couple years ago when we first connected. And I was doing album reviews, but just on our Facebook page, facebook.com/reformbars. And I was mad gritty. I was mad gritty. Just actually disrespectful in a lot of ways. And then Barlow hit me up and he's like, yo, can you do a review of my like two or three songs, maybe small little mixtape. He said, but yo, just send the video to me. Don't make it public. And I respect that because, like I've said before, yeah, I was greedy back then. But I told the truth, but my way of conveying it wasn't God-honoring. I didn't think it was. And so I did a review and hit him back. And what I said to him then, I say to him now. And once again, this is not disrespectful. Barlow is like the Christian Will Smith, right? And what I mean by that is, his style is a comfortable style where he could be at any church event, whether it be First Sunday, whether it be Kids Sunday, whether it be, you know, all black church, all white church, all Hispanic church, all Asian, whatever church. He is, his style and his content is always respectable for both hip hop and for the audience listening, right? And when I say Will Smith, because everybody loves Will Smith. Everybody will bump up. Even thugs have listened to Will Smith songs. They may have, you know, had their views, but they've bumped the song a few million times and then find themselves repeating lines from the song, although in their mind, like, oh, Will Smith is corny, but everybody's talking about getting jiggy with it. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's talking about Big Willie style. Everybody says that, right? And so I said to say, Barlow's style is like that, where it might not necessarily appeal to the thug of thugs, right? But nevertheless, though, you will find thug of thugs wanting to repeat a line into a Barlow, because Barlow's dope like that. He's a very, I don't want to use the word safe, but he is a very safe MC to have around any group of people, right? So, and like I said, the same thing I said about him back then, I'm saying to him now. This album here is a very safe album. I hate using that word, man, but you get my point, though. It's a very safe album. It's a dope album. I enjoyed the album, top to bottom. There's, 10 songs on the album? And my favorite of the 10, top favorite, is a song called Sometimes. It's like track two. That is... I remember, I think, where was I? I was somewhere. I think I was in the gym. I think I was in the gym when I first heard it and had to take a pause for a minute. Because in the song, he's talking about how sometimes he knows that God saved him from sin, saved him from lust, but yet he disrespects God with the sin that he saved him from. And it's just a very, it's a very quick song, about 2, maybe 3 minutes long, a transparent song, just him just talking about how sinful he is in this song, yet he knows God's love is authentic, God's love is real, and he hates the fact that he sins like he sins. And it just hit me, man. Like, I love transparent songs. I love songs with stories. I love when people keep it all, keep all the way a buck in their music, and they let you know, you can feel, enter in and feel them and say to yourself, yo, that's me. Praise God that he put that out there. And I just really enjoyed that song. I enjoyed how he flowed on the song. I enjoyed how the beat matched with him, although it wasn't his beat, but I'll get to that in a second. That's gonna be disrespectful. I love how he flowed with the beat. I love how his whole demeanor on the song. I visualized him singing that, rapping that song in a concert, in a church setting, right? Sitting down, lights kind of dim, and him just pouring his heart out. And I saw many people in the crowd just saying, that's me. And I love that, hands down. Favorite song on the album. My second favorite song on the album is Monogism. I hope I'm saying that right. I always mess some words up, man. But monogism, I'm gonna go with that. although he uses the production, Lil' Kim's Lighters Up, Put Your Lighters Up. I'm gonna get on that. Although he used the production for that, dope song, man. And if you don't know what that means, basically, it's the belief, or the proof, the truth, that the Holy Spirit is one of doing the work in us to bring us to salvation. I love that because of the simple fact that we live in a day and age where people make the statements, or they've always made the statements, but it seems to be growing that one day I just pull myself up on my bootstrap and say, you know, I'm gonna get saved today. No, you didn't choose yourself to be saved. That was the work of God the Father electing you, God the Son dying for you, and God the Son drawing you in, encouraging you, and then and then doing a work in you while you're being in salvation, being shaped and being molded and being grinded and being put in place in which God, in a place in which God has designed for you to be. You yourself didn't save yourself. You yourself didn't make yourself. There's nothing about salvation that will make an unbeliever want to be saved. If you really think about it, that's why I love that song so much, because it's so much truth in it, where there's nothing about salvation, right, that will make a non-believer, a sinful, sin-enjoying non-believer say, you know what, I want to get saved today. That is solely the work of the Holy Spirit. There is solely a work of the Holy Spirit, because the world would say, have sex with as many women as you want, yet Christianity would say, love your husbands, love your wife, as Christ loved the church, and so on and so forth. We can literally go down the line of things that the world pushes and exalts men and women to do, which Christianity says the complete opposite of, but yet we are drawn in by a beautiful God to enjoy a beautiful salvation. Love that song, man, bro. good thing about this album, well, no, this is a bad thing. It's a good thing, but a bad thing. On the very first song, the Underground Railroad, the intro, his beautiful daughter, never met her, but I am a fan of her music. Bree, she's on the song, she's on the intro. I'm mad because there's many other songs, like I said, it's 10 songs, but many other songs on this album where people, you know, are singing and whatnot, and I wish it could have been her. I wish he would have used her more on this album. I don't know why, that's fine, but I wish he would have used her more on this album. I felt this was a great opportunity to introduce the world even though more to her. That's not saying anyone did anything bad. The other artists on this album were good. They really were good. Get that in a second too. I would have wanted to have heard her all the more. Like actually on every song that were a female sung on this album, I would have wanted to be his daughter on this album, because I am a fan of her voice. I'm a fan of her talent. The Lord has definitely blessed her and been gracious to her with the gifting of singing. And I think he would have been dope, and I think he missed opportunity with that. Just be straight with you. I'll keep it a bug with you. Bree, you should have fought for that, shouted. Real talk. But other than that, man, for real, it's a really good album, man. I'm really impressed with the album. Not impressed like, oh my gosh, I didn't know he had skills like that. No, I was impressed with the body of the work because I'm a fan of who he is, but I've always known Barlow has skills. I'm not going to say that I don't find myself at times saying Barlow whenever he comes on a feature song. Barlow is dope, man. Barlow's a dope MC, man. I'm a fan. What I was impressed with, though, was his ability to ride with the beat. So when I used to do Christian rap, you know, when I first started off, I used other people's beats. And it was a struggle at times trying to line my lyrics up with those beats, right? So, and what I did was I wrote my verses first and then went out and searched the beat, right? And when I did that, it was a struggle time to trying to line things up with the breakdown because it wasn't my beat. So it lined up with the breakdowns and just had a third or whatever. And so to see on this album here that he did that, I'm sure it was a struggle at some point too as well or whatnot, but that he did that, like he didn't, like on the song, the D12 song, our production, I think it is what it is. If I'm wrong, I'll put it right here. But on that D12 song, you know, he was it Purple Hill, I think it is. He didn't rap it like them, right? He made it his own, and I love that. I respect that. If you're gonna use other people's beat, bet. Don't copy their style, make it your own. Like literally, if you're gonna take it and say this is mine and I'm going to be me on top of this track. And I love that he did that. If it wasn't for like literally, he could have taken his lyrics off of every single track here and put it on a different song and it would have flowed, or different beat, I'm sorry, it would have flowed just as nice. And I loved it. I think he did a great, this song called Matters. He and I went back and forth on this. I'm a fan of the song, not a fan of the video. And I'm not a fan of the video because of he and our relationship, so I know him, right? And so I know where he stands on certain things. And so when I first saw the video, I'm like, yo, you're leaning too far to the right, you know what I mean? Well, to the right, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying that you gotta lean to the left as well, but I'm saying if you're gonna do it, be in the middle. And I felt like he was more so geared in one direction as opposed to the other. That's just my take from the video. But the song in of itself is beautiful. Song in of itself is phenomenal. I genuinely love that song. I love the message in the song. I love his demeanor in the song. I love how he graciously rebuked everybody in that song. Just a very, very dope song. I want to get the song down real quick, so I'm going to pause this real quick, and I'm going to be right back because I'm about to go in. Love my man, but I'm about to go in. Hold on. Okay. So as you can see, later on in the day, to be straight with you, so and I'm actually heading to take care of a little something. To be straight, I had already recorded what I was going to say, right? And I already, you know, got ready to, I'm in the midst of getting ready to edit and whatever and put, you know, send it to YouTube. And I said, yeah, let me watch one more time real quick what I had just recorded. And although, just keep it frank with you, although I agree everything that I said, and I'm gonna say that again, actually, but my plan is to say it in a much nicer tone as opposed to before. So the song, The Rundown, you know, is a great song, right? Really enjoy that song, really like that song. Think Barlow did a great job on that song as well. Just let's, every song, honestly, think he did a great job. Every song, I really feel like he put his heart into it, put his all into it. He gave us 110%. He did not shortchange us lyrically on this album at all, right? But on the song The Rundown, I really don't like I really don't like the chorus. I feel as if I feel like, oh boy, and it's, you know, it might not be his fault because okay. It sounded like he has skills, so he can sing, right? So it's not necessarily his fault. I think maybe Barlow probably said, and this is just a straight assumption, I don't know, yo, I want you to sing the chorus like this, right? I want you to follow the bass line when you do the chorus. And that sounded not good. That didn't sound good at all, actually. The chorus to me, kind of let the song down, to be straight with you. When the beat first kicked in, right, I'm like, D, D12, right? And I kind of laughed and everything. And I was like, all right, it's whatever. See what he does with it. And he came in, he just kicked it. He killed it. You know, so I was like, whew, praise God. Okay, let's go. And then it got to the chorus. And I was like, wait, what? And I just was taken back and just taken off from the chorus. It almost sounded like he didn't get a chance to prepare for it. Like basically Barlow said at, you know, 2:30, yo, at 3 o'clock we're recording this song, and I need you to be ready. And just gave him the paperwork, whatever, until like 2:45, 2:50. And he walked into the booth naked pretty much and just tried to mash together what Barlow wanted. And it just came across really, really tacky. And I was very disappointed in that song. Didn't like that at all. Also didn't like my man said, "Nevermore." Man, if you don't stop, right? Boy, I was so mad at you. I was so mad at that part, bro. For real, you my guy. I rocks with you, 110. But man, I was like, what in the world are we talking about? I get the reference. I get it. But man, that was corny. Mad, real talk, bro. That was mad corny, bro. Don't you ever do that again. Next album, bro, don't you ever do that again, bro. I was so mad about that. Okay, and then my last pet peeve thing, and this is more on a serious note, and I've made this statement before to other people in our circle, and when I say our circle, I mean those that are connected with facebook.com/performbars. There's a lot of producers, man, on our page, man, in and out of our page, man. We are connected, yo. If you need bars, we got cats with features. If you need artwork, we got cats who can do that. If you need whatever you need, honestly, all you gotta do is put out a post on our page, man. And I promise you, man, by God's grace, 10, 15 people gonna hit you like, yo, what you need? I got you. And we'll go from there. I mean, from Raph and Grace Records to Christ-centric, even my man Nick up in Canada, who's a dope producer, by the way. You can get it, right? And Barlow knows this, right? And so I was really bothered when I'm hearing all 10 songs are beat stolen by from another artist. Secular Christian doesn't really matter to me. The point is, it's somebody else's beat. And I'm mad about that because of the fact that he has access to so many dope producers who could have financially worked something out with them, or but yeah, he could have, you know, hit the squad up. We could have did a GoFundMe page. Not me, I'm broke. But the point is, you know what I'm saying? Something could have been done where it would have worked out, where he could have actually had gotten some original beats. And I get it, right? It's a mixtape. I understand how mixtapes work. I really wouldn't call this a mixtape, really, only because it's a mixtape in the sense of the word, but not a mixtape in the sense of what how a normal mixtape is, where, you know, you have an MC, or not MC, but a host, and then you have, you know, a DJ, and, you know, hold on a sec, gotta be nice. Excuse me. Hello. Your dress is hanging out.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Sorry about that. But you know, I'm not gonna edit that out. Keep it real. But no, you got the DJ, you got the a host, it's a feel. There's a feel for the mixtape. There's more just an album with the title mixtape, right? But anyway, so my point is, I get the point behind mixtape, where you use other jacking for beats, use other people's beats and everything, and then you come in and you spit all those beats. Like I said, to me, this didn't feel like a mixtape, and so he could have gotten away with hitting up Chris Jones, hitting up The Apologist, or Don, or MC Goya, and you know, got a couple beats or whatnot. If he wanted to still use a couple of these other beats, that's fine too, but my point is, he didn't have to go this route. And I just felt we were cheated on that level. I really would have loved to have had some original Barlow, you know, an original Barlow album, you know, so like, I was really looking forward to that. His very first, I was really looking forward to an album that's all his, right? That he had put blood, sweat, and tears in, outside of just the lyrics, you know what I'm saying, but the production as well, and just all that. And I'm not trying to say he didn't do anything, don't misinterpret. I'm not saying he didn't put any blood, sweat, and tears in this. I'm just saying I really would have wanted that, and we didn't get that, you know. And I do feel shortchanged and feel cheated as a consumer. Well, I mean, I ain't paying for it, but you get my point. As a consumer, we were cheated on that because we could have been more. But with all that being said, lyrically, I do strongly believe this was just a, by God's grace, a phenomenal album. Dude, he, like I said before, he didn't try to give us no out of this world big words and didn't try to project his intellect. Nope, it was pretty much, this is how we're going to praise God. Let's just rejoice in the beauty of the Lord and exalt him on high. And I think he did a great job with it. He challenged us with sin, challenged us with the climate of the world, how things are, challenged us with our love for God and our obedience and our ability to repent for sins. And it was a very challenging album, and I very much enjoyed it, and I really praise God for it. And with that being said, man, I encourage you, please go cop the album. Don't rent, don't stream it, don't steal it, definitely don't steal it. Go buy the album, it's worth every penny, man. You won't be disappointed. You know me, I'm gonna keep it a buck, and it wasn't, yeah, you won't be disappointed at all. Next album, man, for real, real, please put Bree on some more. Better yet, you know, let her drop her own. Well, perfect, that's in the works. Let her drop her own and have Cats featuring on that with her own beats. But anyways, yo, that's my thought, my two cents, man. As always, man, like, share, subscribe. Yeah, man, love you, guy. You know that for real, real. All right, y'all, Grace. Real quick, two songs also that I forgot to mention. My God, which actually was originally, I guess, Breathe, but he switched it to My God. Like I said before, I'll say it again, I continue to say, I love when people brag, when Christians brag on the beauty of God. And the chorus was, my God's great, my God's good, my God does things that you wish your God could. Taking that from Ludacris's, all right, man. Taking that from Ludacris's song talking about his girl. But nevertheless, though, I love the truth in it about how awesome and great our God is and how our God is alive, other gods are dead. All gods are other gods outside of our God is dead. And the fact that he said, my God does things your God wish he could, which was Breathe. I'm talking about Christ. He's alive. You know, so I love that. I am such a fan of that song as well. And It Is What It Is, it was a dope song as well. It's a good album, man. I really could brag on this album all day. All the hard stuff that I feel about the album, I've already said, and I meant everything that I said. But at the end of the day, man, dope album. Please go cop it. Sorry to hold you up again. Worth every penny. All right, y'all. Grace.